game.
We're good.
We on?
We're on.
Yep.
Excellent. Okay, welcome back to Fate, everyone.
Ulfgar's gonna do something really stupid now.
Real quick, right. Though, how many hit points do I have at the moment?
Don't make me watch this.
What does Revivify heal? Like one?
It just brings you back to life.
Stable.
Okay, so you're stable, but you're unconscious.
Heal.
You're healed. 70?
Well, I'm gonna need. I'm assuming we're gonna have a long rest shortly here.
That's up to you guys.
Oh, but we don't get to that phylactery.
Fuck, you're right. Well, so not heal.
Yeah.
That is a cure wounds.
Let's do it again tomorrow, guys. Yeah. We beat him once.
Now a long rest isn't 24 hours, but you're still not to the hive yet.
Wait a minute, I've got.
Is there any way we can do it where I only need 4 hours? For a long rest, I'm unconscious. Maybe I could get in the bears. Like
everyone else is damaged.
Yeah, we really. Need
I mean, I can use hit dollar.
We can do a short rest and heal that.
You can use short rest to heal. You will be at least 4 hours more, if not longer, on the walk to the hive. So you can, in theory, trance if you get in the barrel.
Yeah, somebody put me in the barrel.
So
but you're at zero.
Greater what is it? Cure wounds, second level from my necklace, which is a bonus action. I don't use a spell slot.
So we'll just say F it and
that's
fight him again later.
9 plus...
Get our sleep.
I didn't frenzy. I'm not exhausted. All I have to do is heal.
9
I'm
plus
good.
5, so 14 hit points.
Alright, that's
better. I mean, 15.
Terrell needs to use some hit dice as well. Like, several.
I only use one of my rages. I got like 4 left.
And I'm conscious now.
Right? You are conscious now, yes.
I'm just going to use my bag and...
You have just, it kind of, like, seeing Aaron again did trigger
like my
a lot of emotions that you've been dealing with. So we're going to say that you kind of wake up and come to you and you just, like,
I go get
you just,
barrel.
Like, break down.
I literally go get in the barrel and then start,
and
like, crying.
You hear some, like muffled sobs coming from inside of the barrel.
Okay, I'm
the barrel
also...
is my safe zone.
Before you guys, before you guys do your short rest hit die, I'm gonna cast Beacon of Hope.
Nice.
Which maxes
means
out
maxes
healing.
Out.
So just pick how many hit dice you want to use and use the top number.
He's gonna need to use 8 of his 13.
This
so
is
he
after.
Doesn't need to roll those.
I know that. But
this is after.
He needs
rest.
To use
yeah,
8 to get back to full health.
Yeah.
Well, short rest, you can use hit dice to recover your
but
hit points.
But my short rest is now a long rest.
Well, no.
You can take a long rest in
huh?
4 hours.
A couple of months?
Well, I just train.
I don't know. It's awesome.
7 times 8 is 56,
it's,
right?
It's a fun system.
Do you have the
7 times
6?
It's
times
in the
eight.
Binder.
Yeah, 56.
Oh, you're
right. That's all I need to use then. So
yeah.
7 hit dice.
Well, I bought the PDF.
Oh, okay.
And I printed it out.
Only get a 7 multiplied table.
Yep.
Football.
All right.
Oh, sorry.
No.
This is a conversation we could have off.
Yeah, no worries.
Off camera.
You have just survived the Lich, who happened to be passing by and found you guys. Bad luck.
Nagra used a couple, I suppose.
Terrell is going to use 8 of his 13.
I'll use.
To return to full health.
6, 48.
Yes, 5.
6.
Left. Okay.
It comes not.
Time back to field.
Cool beans. Now you go, you continue on your way.
Hi ho. Hi ho. Can we sing?
Sure.
Yeah.
Stealthily.
I'm not singing.
No. He's.
I am. Can we sing in the drow? Silent hand
code.
Yes.
I'm those of you that know it, I guess, in theory you could, but there's no sound, it's not like singing, you're just...
Happy Hands
Club!
Let us worry about that.
Just like motioning words and stuff.
Gang
signs. That's fine, whatever.
Isn't that exactly what an interpretive dance is?
Hey, I used to be a dancer, don't go there.
It's whatever.
But, I mean,
Can you?
It's true.
Interpretive dance is basically singing. What? So.
You're interpreting the lyrics of the song.
Happy and
Cephalosk, as you're kind of walking.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that guy.
Nice job, Squidbeard.
He nods.
It wasn't a compliment, you jackass.
He telepathically communicates with you all.
He can't. He cannot do that.
Oh, that's right, he can't.
That's true.
He's gonna
he has
speak
to talk
then.
In Smeagol voice.
Yes. That's all we want. This is why we have the helmets just for this reason.
Row. We're off to the row. I'm impressed.
Hell, I even died. I'm still here.
Nah. I think, given the right circumstances, that we can do this. We can get the Elder Brain.
Yes.
I can tell why you lot communicate telepathically. If y'all talk like this.
Yes, it's you know.
It's what it is.
No one would be afraid of you with that kind of voice. No one. Actually, what we really need to do is put Nagri in the barrel and let him have a long rest. Because he just used both of his wild shapes.
The wild shapes return after a short rest.
Okay, good.
Which you can do on the walk, so that's fine.
This is my barrel. This is my barrel.
It takes... Okay, so you're walking for about another 12 hours.
Okay.
Getting to the outskirts of the Mind Flayer camp.
I'm going to wait till after...
You can roll that if you wish.
They're gonna need a healer.
yeah.
I can't be insane and healing because he won't really understand why.
You know, use your hit dice to patch yourselves up. You get to kind of the outskirts, and Cephalos kind of stops you guys. Oh. They will recognize your helmets as gift equipment.
Is there a way we can disguise them?
Do you have...
We have a rogue?
Wait. No, I did get... Yes.
You do have the disguise kit, right?
Just got...
Oh, I do too.
Do you have a disguise kit?
Doubtful.
You might be proficient in it.
Hey, hey. I have a disguise kit.
Sai, I'll give you...
We also have Nagri's hat.
I have a hat as well.
Right. Okay, you cannot multi-hat.
We can just...
Yeah, but I have a hat. Can we share hats? Can we, like, sit here and be like...
Does anyone
have
a disguise kit? Like, seeming... Or illusory type spells.
Well, I have a disguise kit, which I could give to Sai.
That's true.
Well, do you have seeming as a spell? I don't.
I'm also very sneaky. I could just not let them see me.
Yeah, it doesn't help the rest of us.
Yeah, I mean, you can very, very likely stealth in there.
Because here's my plan. This is off guard. If we can get close to the Elder Brain and not fight the Mind Flayers on the way, that's the best approach. So, tactically speaking, if we can disguise these helmets and walk like zombies, Squidbeard here can march us straight into the Elder Brain as slaves.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes, I can.
I don't see this going wrong at all.
Neither do I. There's nothing wrong with this plan.
Yeah, I see nothing wrong with this.
This Elder Brain is more powerful, too, than normal.
Great. That's
of course he is.
Why?
Why not?
He gets additional power from this gem is in his...
Describe the gem.
It is a... he kind of holds up a hand. It's about this big.
He doesn't have minor illusion or something to show us a...
Yeah, picture. I mean, yeah, that's fine. He could do that. He just, like, summons this. It's an enormous crystal. It looks, it's clear. It has a faint purplish color. Could be any kind of material.
Would I recognize it? Considering I am a cleric.
Give me a religion check.
Religion, perfect. I got that.
That's or arcana.
Religion, I'm perfect. I got that.
Asking the cleric for religion checks.
That is a 17.
Sure. I'll allow that. 17's going to be high enough for that.
Does he know that it could be destroyed by something?
Well, hold on.
That is, in fact, the phylactery.
So, we're going to the right place because that is the phylactery from the lich that we just killed.
Oh.
Yes.
So,
we need to destroy that anyway.
I kind of want to use...
No.
Take it just because we have to hide
for ourselves.
Why? It doesn't do anything for us, and it only brings that lich back every fucking day.
Yeah, but if you are in possession of a lich's phylactery, you basically are in possession of the lich.
Is that a thing?
Is it like a Pokemon?
It certainly gives you a substantial bargaining chip.
Can we just
throw it in
the bag?
All you have to do
is
say, you do what I say, or I break it, and you die.
I'm gonna kill you.
I mean...
We'll
wouldn't be a bad thing to have in your pocket.
So yeah,
it's a nifty little ace in your sleeve.
So, do we have the ability to disguise these helmets?
We can now. I want to I have invisibility. If I throw that on Imch, whatever he's carrying is also visible.
So hide the barrel.
I am in the barrel.
Do you have greater invisibility?
No.
Okay, so
that also, can,
a couple of things that you know.
Okay.
The helmets will block and do block Illithid power, like charm. Most Illithids have what they call creature sense, which is within 2 miles of it, and an Illithid can detect any creatures that have an intelligence of 4 or higher. You are all, because of the helmets, protected from that. You, of course, take... you're immune to the charm effects of Illithids. And you take half damage from their, psionic blasty blasts. Psychic damage.
Does it also protect us from intellect devourers and the like? Considering they use the same abilities as...
You have not encountered one, so
great.
You
perfect.
Do not.
We were not told.
You were not told.
So,
shit.
So with these helmets, they basically, if we went in and disguised ourselves, they wouldn't be able to detect us as creatures.
And
right.
So we have
this
to.
Plan. Ready?
No, go for it.
The beauty of this plan is that Squidbeard, because that's your new name.
This is Uncle Frosty. You call him that.
Here's the problem, too.
Well, no, wait. I wanted to explain my
okay.
The geniusness of this plan. Squidbeard is separate from the Hive. So, if they can't tell our minds, if they can't sense us, he can just say that that's because he's in control of our minds. And they have to believe him, because he can lie to them. I hope. I'm assuming. Is that correct, Squidbeard?
No.
Okay, I was wrong.
Okay, so they... I'm going to go into DM speak here. They can't detect you. If they see you and they reach out and they can't detect you, it's not going to matter that they can't see the helmets. They know something's up.
Yeah.
That you're protected somehow. Whether it's with rings of mind shielding or whatever. There are items that exist outside of Gith technology that kind of do the same thing. Or similar things. The helmet is more complete a protection than any other items, like the rings or whatever. Because it also safeguards your head from, brain consumption. Yeah. Tasty Brains.
Oh. I was just reminded of, I think it's, whichever Dritz book, whenever the, and then the Baron Zong goes to war against Mithril Hall.
Mm-hmm.
And you have Harple and the other, wizard lady that cast, transmutate on themselves, or not transmutate, polymorph on themselves to redistribute their anatomy.
Yeah.
And change where they're.
Yeah.
They change.
That was actually brilliant.
They put their brains in their butts and their butts in their brains.
Yeah.
Can we do that?
Those are the Harples.
The Harples, yes.
Oh gosh, that is such a good. It's so good. Like a partial polymorph.
Yeah.
To change the location of their brains.
Like they just sat there while the lithids like tentacled up and burrowed into their heads, and they're just sitting there. And so it was all worth it just to see their milky white eyes just go whenever they got it and get
and
brains.
It's like, gross. Gross.
All right, Salvatore, that was brilliant. I applaud you.
If you're watching, Bob, that was great.
It sure was.
Also, Bob, if you're watching.
For reals. Okay.
Please. Please be watching.
Please.
Big fan. Big fan.
Come join us. Bring a character.
Yeah.
we'll come join you.
We'll come join you. We'll pay for our interview.
Is there any planning you want to do? Like Heroes Feast?
Okay.
Or
I could do that.
I said, is there
but I can't do
something
that
along
I can't
those
do that
lines?
I could try to disguise everyone's things, but like, is there something that we could maybe, like some sort of like plant or
we could
something? I was gonna say, like try to basically cover it up, make it almost look like we have like wigs over, make it like we have hair.
Well, that is what you'll be rolling for and describing how you're trying to mask the helmets, and we'll see how well you do.
Well,
could make cloaks.
Now, what? Will invisibility work with if I'm in the barrel, because it says anything
invisibility, that's a great question.
Would also be invisible.
Can you cast it at higher level to affect more creatures?
I think that's what invisibility does.
Okay. If you can
hire one additional creature, but what I'm saying is just at the level it is, it says anything the target is wearing or carrying is invisible.
You do not have Imps equipped. You do not. That is not how that works.
But I have him equipped.
that's, he does.
He is
in
the
barrel.
Oh my god.
That's where we're going at.
DM, does that work? Because, I mean, technically speaking.
Because we'll say, hypothetically, Harry Potter rolls, the cloak is surrounding it. What was inside the cloak was him. So the barrel would just be covering it. That would be invisible.
All right. The idea intrigues me. So what we're going to do is have a serendipity roll off.
Woo! Roll off, okay.
I'm going to roll and you're going to roll. And whoever's higher...
You're going to have how many times?
We will say...
Whoever's closer to the number 42.
Would you best 2 out of 3?
No.
No, I did really bad.
I got 22.
Yeah, you beat me by double.
You rolled 11. Okay, so no. Well, you can cast it at a higher level, and it will affect
both creatures.
More creatures. So
you can get all of us.
When you go,
I can go to 7, but this.
Hagrid can apparently cast invisibility.
Cephalosk can himself become
for
invisible.
Each level, so 1, 2, 3, 4.
Well, technically he can't, but actually he doesn't have to go invisible because
he's a mind flayer.
Yeah.
So I can take 5 creatures as well as him.
I have an idea for the disguise.
And we have disguise. So.
Cloaks with fake tentacles coming out of them attached to our faces. Do some makeup. We'll look like mind flayers if they don't look too closely.
Okay, question. Because the disguise kit is not, it's like not a huge box full of like random shit you can use. Like what are you using for the tentacles?
Okay, can we I mean, I know that the Underdark has its own, like, foliage system.
Yes.
And, like, that sort of stuff. So, could we try to...
Forage?
Yeah, forage for some... Use, like, nature. To try to forage for some...
Okay, usable. Give me a nature check.
Well, the only problem I see that
I saw all
is
no.
They still won't be able to sense us.
Make it survival.
Alright. Oh, yeah, that would be survival.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Wait.
We're going
in this. Can I put...
Wait.
Sergei's head over
first,
the top of my head? I think I still have
let's
it.
Do nature. Are any of you...
We're all proficient.
Well, I'm proficient in nature.
Well,
no,
I realize that, but the only one... Okay, this will be nature at disadvantage to know what kind of thing you're looking for first.
Okay.
And then
unless... Whoever, well, except for Isaac Schmidt, because he's actually from the Underdark.
And whoever passes...
He can just roll nature normal.
Can actually try to...
Can describe or whatever.
And disadvantage?
Yeah!
If that hadn't been the disadvantage, I would have had 19.
I held
21.
20... By disadvantage?
Oh, this...
Right. Hey, so I'm rolling just normal.
Ha! Roll the same number twice.
Yes. 21 is good.
I got 22.
22, okay. 18.
Oh, I had a 9.
9.
What's
the 4?
You got a 1.
Now you're gonna
5.
That's
a 1 and a 19 for Terrell. So,
I got a 3 and a 19.
Between Eisenschmidt and Sai, you kind of know what you're looking for.
Okay.
I'm not going to give a name for it because I don't care enough to
yep.
bother
we're looking
with
for
that.
The blah blah plant.
Right. You were
that's
looking
a good
for the blah
for
blah
it.
Plant.
It is the blah blah plant.
Actually,
there's the name. Name.
There is
they basically look like seaweed, like where like,
what
like
is
wavy
that
and
cave.
It's in the
air. Like the old Greg's hair.
I've seen it in.
Yeah, that's.
I seen it. There it is.
Can I be old Greg?
What you doing in my wands?
You're looking for cave light moss.
Oh, that works. We should take the lights off.
What you doing in my wands? Yeah.
Now.
Now we do the
survival.
It's not bad.
That is an 11.
That is a
22. Oh yeah.
Can I have advantage because I
Imsha has a 24?
Sure.
Nagri got a 27.
I have no.
No.
For survival?
Yeah.
Damn.
Imsha got a 24, Nagri got a 27. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, Nagri is a druid, so that's fair. Okay. You kind of rummage around the winding caverns in the Underdark, and you come upon a kind of glowy area that is cave-like moss. It is not a super high challenge rating, so we're not even going to bother with the fight. It's like CR4.
We kill it.
So, it would be arbitrarily time...
Dude, Cephalos could just mind blast it.
Time waste... Well, no, not in one move, but... We'll say for the sake of discussion that, and to speed things along, that you are able to acquire a bit of cave-like moss.
Do we still get the XP?
We have gone away from XP because at this point you need so much XP that it's
ridiculous.
He's just gonna say, and you leveled up.
We are now milestone based. So
I prefer milestone.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Straight XP is just not fun. It takes way too long.
You have cave light moss, you have the disguise kit. I believe you all have cloaks of some kind or another, so that's just like regular clothes.
Do we have to roll for how successful our disguises
you
are?
You have to.
Yes, you do.
Both of you, since you're making the disguises.
You are going to roll... I need my book.
Well, so probably wouldn't be two individual rolls.
They're
it'll probably
dressing
be
us up.
One roll with assist.
Okay, so...
With
okay. With an assistant...
What's your
invisible?
With assist, you'll have advantage.
Okay, what's the, is it stealth?
It is... That is a good question, actually. I'm not sure. Disguise...
Your proficient
kit. Let me look. Hang on. I don't know that it specifies...
that. I just had it up, so... If you guys take my hat...
We can't wear a hat on top of the helmet.
No. Yeah. Yep. Is that healer's kit, druidic focus.
I mean, I'm just a big old dick. I can wear the hat on my dick.
You're invisible. You don't need it.
Really? You went there? All right. No. So.
Oh, shit. I'm really short.
That's time.
Oh, okay. Cool. Planning.
I don't think there are such things as short mind flayers.
Nope.
How short are you?
Go ahead, and we will be right back. With the next phase
I'm
here.
I'm a medium-sized creature, but I'm probably about 4'9". Is that about how tall dwarves are?